notified me that it was possible to hold the opinion hypothetically, as Copernicus did.
Can Galileo explain what is in his book, which he imagines was the reason for the order that he appeared before us?
Well, when I was writing the dialogue, I did not do so because I held that the doctrine of Copernicus was true. Instead, I set forth the astronomical reasons that could be advanced on either side of the debate. I tried to show that neither side of the argument has conclusive force to favor one opinion over the other. I do not now hold, and since the determination of Cardinal Bellarmine, I have not held the condemned opinion.
Todos que leram Diálogo podiam ver que a defesa de Copérnico era o argumento mais forte do livro. O personagem Simplício, repetindo as palavras de Urbano VIII, era mais uma sátira que ciência. Galileu foi obrigado a demonstrar uma falsa humildade, e isso nunca foi seu estilo.
With respect to the court, I've recently reread my dialogues. After 3 years, and I freely concede that in several places a reader ignorant of my real purposes could suppose several arguments might suggest real conviction on my part. My error, I confess, was one of ambition. The natural inclination of most men with regard to their subtleties to show themselves more skillful than other men in devising arguments in favor of propositions, even false propositions.
Galileu foi mandado para um pequeno quarto do Palácio da Inquisição. Parecia certo que seu livro seria banido. A questão agora era qual castigo cairia sobre o próprio Galileu.
It very quickly boiled down to a technicality. In 1616, Galileo had agreed not to teach or defend the Copernican theory. The accusation was he had violated this agreement. And Galileo said, no, I didn't violate the agreement. If you see, by the time you read the end of the book, I come out in favor of the church's position, and I just bring up these other arguments as an arguing tool. Well, anybody who read the book knew better.
A notícia da prisão de Galileu chegou a Maria Celeste, e ela enviou uma carta aconselhando cautela, sem saber se a carta chegaria até seu pai.
Detido nas câmaras do gabinete sagrado. Eu não falei sobre essas dificuldades a mais ninguém e guardei as desagradáveis notícias para mim mesma. Pai, agora é hora de usar a prudência que Deus lhe concedeu.
O caminho que Galileu percorreu até as câmaras onde ouviria sua sentença passava pelas clausuras de Santa Maria sopra Minerva. As paredes e o teto alertavam os hereges sobre o destino que podia aguardá-los.
The people who were conducting the Inquisition hope that anybody who's coming into the Inquisition sees these scenes of people who've died in the correct faith. Realize that they should use the courage of the martyrs to confront their own case, face their heresy squarely and go off to their punishment with a clean conscience because it's been brought back to orthodoxy.
Na manhã da sentença, Galileu foi levado novamente até a Inquisição, desta vez vestindo a túnica branca de um penitente.
We pronounce sentence. We declare that you, Galileo Galilei, by reason of the matters detailed in this trial, have rendered yourself in the judgment of this holy office vehemently suspected of heresy. Namely, having held and believed a doctrine which is false and contrary to Scripture, that the sun is the center of the world and does not move, that the earth is not the center of the world and does move, we condemn you to formal imprisonment in this holy office at our pleasure.
Eles chegaram a um acordo. Galileu teve a chance de renunciar a seus erros. Em vez de passar o resto da vida em uma masmorra, Galileu se ajoelhou, como mandaram.
Galileo, son of Vincenzo Galilei Florentine, 70 years of age, kneeling before you, swear that I have always believed, I believe now, and with God's help, I will always believe all that has been taught, held, and preached by the Holy Catholic Church. I abjure with unfeigned faith and sincere heart. I curse and detest many errors and heresies. So help me God. Amen.
O julgamento de Galileu havia acabado. Esperando na embaixada da Toscana, ele levou meses para saber quando poderia voltar para casa. Diálogo sobre os sistemas máximos foi acrescentado à lista dos livros proibidos. O livro permaneceria proibido nos 200 anos seguintes. Galileu acreditava que o Papa Urbano VIII o protegeria da censura, mas ele não o fez.
Being the Pope is different from being the Cardinal. The Pope had many battles to fight, the most important being the Protestant Reformation. And there he was, the head of the Catholic Counter-Reformation, and Urban was actually accused of not doing the right things to further the Catholic cause.
The Pope maintained interest in what Galileo was doing. But the Pope, in many ways, had other concerns besides science. Urban VIII is facing the 30 Years' War. The entire reign is under the shadow of a terrible, vicious civil war that's tearing apart the Christian world.
So when Galileo came to trial, the Pope could not risk defending his friend when he personally was under such scrutiny, and Galileo became expendable.
He feels he can afford to turn his back on Galileo, and I think Galileo didn't know what was coming. Tuscany at that point has nothing but culture. Galileo is their vanguard of scientific thought. Galileo gets silenced by the Pope. So it's a Tuscan turning back and smacking his Tuscan friend, who he feels smacked him at the end of this dialogue, so that it's a wonderful Florentine vendetta.
Seis meses após o julgamento, a notícia que chegou a Florença foi de que Galileu poderia voltar para casa. Graças aos apelos do embaixador da Toscana, à intervenção da família Médici e à sutil influência da própria filha.